Mammography is the most useful tool we have for the early detection of breast cancer. It has a sensitivity and specificity that far outperform any other modality. And so we are able to pick up cancers typically at least a year before they are palpable, and breast cancers that are much smaller than would be seen that if the woman had felt it herself. Over the last 40 years, we've seen the mortality or death rate from cancer drop nearly 40%, and this is due to the institution of widespread screening mammography. So there are many other imaging modalities for the breast. Mammography is the most tested and also the most reliable imaging modality that we have to detect early breast cancer. It is the one that has been tested on hundreds of thousands of people, has been scrutinized for the last 40 years, and so we are confident in its ability to detect breast cancer. That said, we have other modalities such as ultrasound and MRI, and those are useful typically in adjunct to mammography, and in certain patient populations, they can increase our detection rate of cancer. They are rarely or never a standalone or replacement for mammography. Like any test, mammography has its pros and its cons, and the weaknesses that it has, number one, is with women that have dense or extremely dense breast tissue. We've overcome some of that with the 3D technique, the tomosynthesis, that tends to unmask breast masses better, and also tends to clarify things that might have been thought to be a mass but turn out to be just superimposed tissue. So it's been a great adjunct to our armamentarium of breast cancer screening tools. 3D tomosynthesis breast mammography is not only increases specificity but sensitivity for breast cancer detection. Also, for certain breast cancers are just like anything, are not seen with mammography. Women that are at high risk for breast cancer because of genetic mutations, or young women, mammography tends to perform less well, and that's why we do breast MRI in those patients as well.